डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी अंडरटेक ए न्यू पोएम फॉर आवर डिस्कशन नेम टाइगर रिटन बाय विलियम ब्लेक. आई थिंक दैट दिस पोएम इज ए ग्रेट पोएम इन द सेंस दैट इट हैज फोकस्ड अपॉन द ग्रेट mystic relationship which exists between the world and the Almighty. We find that in the history of English literature, Tiger is recognized as a memorable and significant piece of poem for many reasons. We cannot say that it is simply the poem around the tiger. Rather, it is a poem around the tiger with certain philosophy that we could not simply demystify, despite the fact that we have been talking about that philosophy for thousands of years. You know, this world and its regulator had been not deciphered correctly. Or there are many ways by which people have lighted upon this mystic idea. But William Blake is a poet, but very philosophically he is talking about that mystic theme in his poem. He has taken the example of tiger on the one hand, and he has taken the example of lamb on the other. And by these two examples, he has tried to say that it is just wonderful creation of the Almighty. How can you believe that both the creatures have been created by the same God? Now, it is within this question that he tries to find the answer to the question. We can say that he has so many points to present in his argument, and he has to conclude on the basis of very much rational, you know, argumentative discussion in the poem. I am Dr. Naveen Kumar Jha, Associate Professor in English, RAGS College, Ahilya Sthan. Now we are going to talk about the poet as a visionary one. Now he has a vision to see beyond the horizon. He is not simply observing the fact which lies on the surface level. Yes, we can say that on surface level there is one reality that we see, but at deeper level there is another reality that we have to come through. It is just like the example of fish in water. As you all know that it is all due to the incident of refraction. The swimming fish does not have the actual appearance where it is swimming. So it is a kind of just making the adjustment between the false appearance of fish and the real position of the fish. A visionary poet tries to go to that actual position of idea on the basis of observation of the appearance of the fact. So we see that it is not an easy going process, and it requires lots of understanding of life and insight into the fact and situation. This poem is also going to expose the fact that Blake is a visionary poet who has the capacity for going through the inner existence of the thing on the basis of the observation of the fact at surface level. So his poem is widely anthologized. He has composed several poems, and especially this poem has a question to answer. He tries to find the answer to the question about the nature of God and creation. Now, in philosophy, we find that it has been the moot point that God is the creator of this universe. There is a group of philosophers who believes that because this world is a design, so God is the designer of this world. He believes that every design is made by a designer. So, if you suppose that this world is a design, definitely we can say that there will be a designer. The poet Blake is not clearly following this principle that the God is the designer of this world, in the sense that God has made tiger on the one hand and the vulnerable being lamb on the other. Rather, in the beginning of the poem, he gets surprised to see this kind of contrast. Actually, we find that he is taking resort to contrast of the world to draw the conclusion. You know, we live with contrasts. Life is itself full with contrasts. Or rather, contrast makes so many things clear. Generally, you find that we want to live into a very similar situation. We want to find a mate very much equal to our thought, that we can very peacefully spend our life. But if there is only the similarity of the thing, we cannot make distinction between day and night, because these are two contrasting realities which exist all because of their contrasting existence. We can say what day is not right, and what right is not day. The negation of one thing is enough for the existence of another thing. So, for existence of both the things, day and night, we have to accept the contrasting features which are lying to make distinction between these two realities. Likewise, you can say there are two contrasting realities, contrasting beings, tiger and lamb. We can be surprised to see that the same fearful tiger has been designed by God, as the same meek being like lamb has also been designed by God. But he perhaps tries to say that yes, this is what the capability of God is. We find that the idea of creation in the mind of God must have come through the fact that just he is capable of making and creating lots of contrasting things in this world. And the more contrasting thing we are making, the better creator we are known. So, here the question is whether the same God created vulnerable beings like the lamb and the fearsome tiger. Actually, it is very much surprising to find these two things. Likewise, we can find that there are so many surprising things which are just in this world, like black people and white people. These are two contrasting shapes or racial groups of human beings. Rather, there are so many contrasting features very much present in our body. And the presence of each and every contrasting thing is essential for organismic running of this body. We simply cannot say that it is only by one similar function of the organ, or let all organs function similarly to continue the organismic whole of this body. We are by our nature not ready to accept that reality, that we cannot live with contrasting things. We cannot accept the contrasting thing taking place side by side. But we find that to view two different colors like black and white, there are some contrasting features just within. Otherwise, these two colors would not be differentiated. So we find that wonder is okay. The poet wonders at the tiger and its fearsome power. We are also wondering, seeing so many contrasting things in the world. And we only think that no, God cannot make this fearful tiger, because God cannot be destructive. God is not the creator who would try to make His creation fearful by His another creation. How can God be so? We have described by different adjective like kind, simple, you know, just sublime, just equitable, and so on. We always try to explain God in terms of very positive words, that the very much God is just to help us. The very much God is just to make the world move smoothly. But William Blake thinks that no, it is not the real thing. In reality, we should not accept the fact that this world is made of similar things. Or if this world is made of similar things, had this world been made of similar things, this world would not have been as it is, or would not have been knowing the Creator God as we are knowing. Why do we accept His greatness? We accept His greatness all because of the fact that He is capable of making contrasting things in this world. We admit the existence of God because of the fact that we know that these sorts of contrasting things are not to be made by common people. Common people are not going to make the creation like wall, because he is simply not capable of making the world full with contrast and contrast and contrast. It is only by God, and so God is everywhere in all creation. In Hindu Shastra, we find that in all creations, God lives. Whether it is tiger, whether it is lamb, whether it is stone, whether it is tree. We believe that God is living in all the things, because they are all just reflecting on the Creator. They are all showing that, okay, they have been made by the same Creator, that is God. So we go to the extent, you know, he has taken the example of only just two living beings. After all, tiger too is a living being and lamb too is a living being. But we have gone to the extent of the fact that we have thought that even in an inanimate being like a stone is just going to reflect on the Creator. Even we can say that tree is the just what he can call created by Almighty. It is the same. same existence, same being living even in tree, even in water, even in fish, even in human being, even in tiger, even in lamb. So our Hindu philosophy is very broad in the sense that in all natural objects, and we even consider that everything is the natural just thing, including human being. We are all the just part of nature, or it is all the natural system in which everything is living. We cannot say that the existence of man is more important than existence of just a tiger or existence of lamb. Tiger, see, it's just a tiger is the poem where you find that both the things are living, just in contradiction with each other. We know that one is very simple, another is very much destructive. One is very simple, another is very complex. And despite the fact, they are two realities of the world. They live together. And it is here the greatness of God is realized. The God is just going to make this kind of a strangeful thing in this world. It is all the strangeful thing made by God, which is just a very much essential proof that God exists, being all powerful. Otherwise, we human being has also made so many things, but we have not made two contrasting things all the same time, as a tiger and the lamb. So we find that this tiger was published as part of experience section of Songs of Innocence and Experience. Here itself we find that he believes in contradiction. The title Songs of Innocence and Experience also consists of two opposite words, innocence and experience. We cannot be at the same time innocent, or we cannot be at the same time experienced. These are two realities. So knowledgelessness is our innocence, and knowledgefulness is our experience. But two live together. There are two sides of human, or just what you can call natural world. And you find that in this biodiversity, it is the being which is very simple, and it is also the being which is very complex in its just a cellular construction and structure. We simply cannot believe that amoeba is also made by the same Almighty who has made human being also. So just from the title of Songs of Innocence and Experience, it becomes clear that William Blake is always going to find the idea of contrast to be the basic thing for the best able creator, who is otherwise known as God. So now finally, when just we start the poem, we find that we start from a surprise, and just to the end, we find he is himself raising lots of questions within, because when he is seeing tiger, just he is very much surprised, you know, how brilliantly, how just skillfully it has been made. Rather, it is a skill of God, which has been the very much factor behind making of this kind of thing. But ultimately, all the symmetrical composition of tiger, it's just going to make it beautiful. On the one, it looks beautiful. On the other hand, it is very much dangerous. How can you believe that beautiful thing may be dangerous? But seeing the tiger, we can say that we come across the fact that tiger looks beautiful, but tiger is dangerous also. So just we want to see tiger for its beauty, but we want to go away from tiger for its just dangerous nature. You know, the same thing consists of two opposite characters. On the one end, we are just ensnared by beauty of tiger, but just a sense of
just what you can call fear is evoked in our mind, and so we stand in surprise. We simply are just not able to see. It is what the mystic question is. Just we believe or we don't. It is what the question is. And it is what the mysticism is. When you find that this kind of two contrasting situations are coming just all at the same time, we are very much into just what you can call mystical composition of the world. We are just simply illusioned to see this kind of thing, the beauty and danger, just having kept in the same creation, in tiger. So, on the one hand, William Blake is praising God for his strong skill by which he has made a very beautiful and symmetrical tiger, which looks very nice. But on the same time, you find that it appears to be very much dangerous thing. Yes, it appears to be very much dangerous, and at the same time, it looks dangerous. And we people are very much what he can call made fearful at the appearance of tiger. So we stand in surprise, we get surprised, and we are simply left with the question. Although at the surface level, the poet leaves us with the question whether we should accept that the same God has given these two contrasting features to tiger. Now let you decide, let reader decide. But he is convinced, internally speaking, that yes, it is none but God who can do this work. We are actually in surprise. We actually do not drive the conclusion that, okay, finally it is God who has made, and it is by God everything has been made, or within the same thing there are so many contrasting things made by God. It is for us just not easy to accept. So we remain with the question. As we start with the question, we remain with the question because it is not clearly said. It is not clearly said. Yes, it is always question mark, one question after another question which has been raised in the poem. But what is the intention of the poet to make so many questions in the poem? Because elocutionary speaking, he tries to conclude that yes, God is capable of doing this kind of thing. And we find he raises the question, but question for what? Question for making the conclusion that it is none but God able to do this kind of thing. So sometimes we find the answer is within the question. There are questions which are containing their own answers. They are not questions as a matter of fact. They seem to be questions, structurally speaking, but the force within the questions are just the admittance of certain fact that the poet has admitted through the questions, raising so many questions. When we are raising so many questions, we are actually trying to prove something that is very much in our mind. So it is also the way to prove something. It is all just a reasonable way to say something, convincing way to say something, that he is not asking questions, rather he believes and he admits that these questions are very much answers to the mystery question, whether God has made all these things. Yes, he wants to say that God has made all these things. So we can say that it is all about the poem, and we know that Tiger, the poem, has been first published in 1794, and this poem is the extension of the power of both nature and God. We can say he believes in nature. This natural world is the manifestation of God, and you find in nature there are so many contradictory things. They will be there. It is but the just a nature of a nature that it contains, it consists of lots of contradictory things. Otherwise, the beauty of the nature will be lost and will not be remembered God as we are remembering Him. So, it is what? The very much actual thing is there, and we are very much going to find this kind of idea that is just behind the poem with which the poet has come, and we have started today. It is what the context is there, background of this poem is here that we have talked. But later on we can say that we are going to talk about so many things. Thank you very much.